Ramayana, Part 35. Sugreeva's army performs a great feat. Sugreeva had promised to help Sri Rama trace Sita, but it was difficult to carry out the search in the rainy season, and so they decided to begin the quest once the rains had ended. Sri Rama and Lakshmana stayed on in the forest. The rains receded, and it was now autumn. The forest put on new glory now. Wherever one looked, green greeted the eyes. Sri Rama remembered Sita and sighed deeply. Sugreeva, now the kingdom of Kishkindha, was immersed in the administration. He had completely forgotten his promise to Sri Rama. He himself, his wife and children and his kingdom, these were all that mattered to him, and he was oblivious of everything else. One day, Hanumantha urged Sugreeva, "Sugreeva, what has happened to you? You have forgotten the favor that Sri Rama did you. Is this right? Good people never forget the help they receive. However small the favor, it remains green in their memory, and they endeavor to do something in return. You gained the kingdom by Sri Rama's favor. He reunited you and your wife. What great favors he has conferred. You should ever remain grateful to him, and you ought to render whatever service you can. But what have you actually done? You have clean forgotten them. You have neglected your promise to help him. Poor man, he has lost his wife and is a wanderer in the forest. And here in the palace, you are lost in pleasures. This is improper. The rains have receded. At least now, take up the task of finding Sita Devi." At this very time, Sri Rama sent Lakshmana to Sugreeva. Lakshmana said to Sugreeva, "Sugreeva, the rains are over. You had promised to help us, but you are lost in selfish pursuits and have forgotten your word. My brother is miserable because of separation from Sita. Well, at least tell me whether you will help us find Sita or not." Sugreeva now woke up. He realized that he had been in the wrong. He said, "Lakshmana, I have been remiss in my duty. I shall not delay any more. I will come with you to the forest straight away and meet Sri Rama. We will attend to your work from today." He went to Sri Rama with leaders like Hanumantha. He bowed to him and said, "I am guilty of a grievous offense. I pray to you to forgive me. I have not forgotten my promise to you. I shall start the search for Sita Devi right away." He then summoned his commander-in-chief, Neela, and the entire Vanara army. Lakhs of Vanaras who lived on the Mahendra, the Himamanta, the Vindhya, the Kailas, and the Mandara mountains responded. Some of them were black, some grey, and some red. The grey ones were innumerable. The Vanaras were endowed with a variety of capabilities. They could run very fast. They could leap very high. They were skilled in martial arts. These valiant forces came up to Sugreeva. Monkeys and bears crowded so that the forest overflowed with them. Sugreeva now addressed Sri Rama. "Sri Rama, have you seen this huge army? All these are warriors of exceptional valor. They are heroes. Nothing is impossible for them. They can leap overseas. They can climb mountains. They can leap to the sky. They fight valiantly. They will leave straight away in search of your wife. I will send them to different corners. Wherever Sita Devi may be, they will find her." He then divided the Vanara army into four parts. He made a Vanara, Vinata by name, the leader of the first group. Hanumantha was the leader of the second group, Sushena of the third, and Shatabali of the fourth. Then Sugreeva addressed his forces. "You know that Ravana, the king of Lanka, has carried away Sita Devi, the wife of Sri Rama. We do not know where Ravana has hidden Sita Devi. In Lanka or somewhere else in the world. It is now our duty to find her. So set out straight away. Go in four directions. Look for Sita Devi everywhere. Sri Rama has laid us under an immense obligation. Let us search out his beloved wife and repay the help in some measure. He who locates Sita Devi will equal me in glory." He sent Shatabali to the north, Vinata to the east, and Sushena to the west. He then called Hanumantha and said, "Hanumantha, you are a master of speed. You can travel where you will. You can travel unimpeded in the sky or in the sea. You can visit the realm of the gods and that of the Gandharvas. You are valiant and wise. So, I repose the greatest confidence in you. Your share of the responsibility of finding Sita Devi is great. I feel only you can accomplish this task. Lanka is to the south, so go to the south and search for Sita Devi. Sri Rama listened to Sugreeva's words. He was happy that Hanumanta was Sugreeva's trusted friend. He also felt that only Hanumanta could find Sita. He took his ring off his finger and said, "Hanumanta, keep this ring. When you see my wife, show her this ring. She will recognize it as mine and talk to you freely." Hanumanta received the ring reverently with both hands and made it secure. The armies of monkeys spread out in different directions as Sugreeva had instructed. Confident of discovering Sita, they set out excited and enthusiastic. The force commanded by Shatabali, which went northward, searched for Sita in Prasthala, Mlecha, Pulinda, Shurasena, Kuru and Madradesha. It continued the quest in Kamboja, Yavana, Shaka, Bahlika, Rishika, Purava, Sheena and Mahachina. It scoured the lower regions of the Himalayas and the summits of Kala Parvata in the caves of Sudarshana Parvata and the Devashaka Parvata ranges in Mount Kailash and Mount Kanchi Parvata. It looked for Sita in Kranchagiri, where Devas and Gandharvas reside. Vinata, one of Sugreeva's generals, went eastward with his powerful army of monkeys. They searched the forests, the mountains, and the river banks in the eastern region. They looked for Sita Devi on the banks of the Ganga, the Sarayu, the Kaushiki, the Yamuna, which is well known as the Kalindi, the Saraswati, the Sindhu, and the Shona. They also went to the kingdoms of Brahmamala, Videha, Malava, Kashi, Kosala, Magadha, Pundra and Wanga. They looked for her in the regions of several mountains, the Mandara, the Rishabha, the Udaya Parvata, as well as Yavadvipa, Suvarnadvipa and Kshirasagara. To the west went another general, Sushena. His army scoured several kingdoms like Saurashtra, Bahlika, Shura, Bhima and Kukshi, as well as the western coast. It visited the Avanti and the Angalepa river banks, the mountain called Hemagiri, the Kanchana Shikara, Mount Varaha and Meru Parvata, known as the King of Mountains. The Vanaras entered the forest. They felled plants and trees. They shouted. The forest animals were scared by the hubbub and fled. The noise they made filled the skies, but search as they might, the Vanaras could not find Sita. They did not find her on the sea coast, or at the bottom of the sea, or in the mountain and forest caves. The Vanaras climbed mountains. They pushed aside boulders to see if there were pits. They climbed to the top of the mountains and gazed around, but there was no sign of Sita. They went to different cities and kingdoms. They inquired if persons had newly come there. They looked for Sita among the new arrivals. They looked for her in every town and every house. But she was nowhere to be found. They were unhappy. All the groups, except the one which had gone southwards, returned disappointed to Kishkindha.